It's camping season, so let's go over camping memberships. We're gonna go over 5, 4 of which we use. We'll tell you the sneaky reason why we didn't use the last one, and we're gonna tell you which ones are good if you're full-time RVers or weekend warriors. Stay tuned.
Hey everybody, welcome back to the RV Odd Couple. My name is John.
And I'm Mercedes. Long story short, we sold all of our possessions to RV full-time with a toddler and a dog.
And in today's video, we are going to talk about campground memberships.
So let's dive into campground memberships. The first one we're going to talk about is the one that we think is a great deal, whether you full-time or part-time RV, and that is Passport America.
It's a no-brainer, guys.
It's awesome. For only $44 for the year, it entitles you to 50% off of camping in a whole bunch of locations. But bottom line is that that one is awesome, because if the average RV park is about $50 a night and you stay 2 nights, you've saved $25.
Pays for itself.
You've made $8.
And there's some really nice parks in that system.
Yeah, and they cover the whole U.S. pretty good, so we really enjoy that one.
Yep, so click the link above and check that video out if you care to. A little bit more in detail on that one.
The next campground membership is kind of a monstrosity of a beast. It's Thousand Trails, Encore, Trails Collection, and we have a whole 30 some odd minute video.
32 minute video that we'll connect to right here. If you want to know about Thousand Trails long-term memberships, click that link.
It's been a hit, and it goes really in depth on the Elite and Odyssey and a little about the camping pass too. But for this video, we want to focus more on the camping pass. And so the camping pass, for $585, you get to pick one zone out of the continental U.S.
5 total.
Yeah, there are 5 total, and you can add additional zones for like $54. And so that one we think is a really good one if you're maybe considering an Elite membership, but you want to test it out. Now that is $585 for the year, so that is a lot pricier than Passport America for sure. But a couple of things. Number one, if you're like a weekend warrior and you're in a geographic zone that really corresponds to those zone passes, you could really get mileage out of that. And some of those resorts are really nice. And the other thing that's awesome about it is that for that $585, you can qualify to purchase the Trails Collection add-on, which that has really, really nice resorts. And that's a $214 add-on that you pay the same price if you get the zone for $585 that you would if you bought the Ultimate Odyssey that's thousands of dollars. We love our Thousand Trails Elite Connections membership, but that zone pass, either if you're like a part-timer, you're staying to a certain geographic area, or let's say you're a 50-50 boondocker slash park goer, then the zone pass would probably be good if you're full-time or part-time. So it's something to really weigh, because the cost is a lot more steep than the Passport America, but it's a really good deal if you consider the niceness of those resorts.
And within the camping zone pass, you can stay at any Thousand Trails resort within that regional area for up to 14 nights. And then you need to be out of the system for 7 days. And then you can go back into the same park or another park in that regional zone. Also, there's a little bit of a hack here. If you go to a park and stay 4 nights or less, you can bounce park to park without getting out of the system.
That's right. So if you want to stay put for 2 weeks and you have another place to go for the week, it's awesome. Or let's say you like to move a lot, which we don't. We like to kind of go a little bit slower. If you like to move a lot and you don't mind going 4 days, then it's really worth considering.
And as Mercedes talked about, that add-on with the Trails Collection is fantastic. Depending on your zone, Florida and Arizona have quite a few parks where it's an additional $20 per night. But these parks are truly resorts. It's worth every penny. Most of the parks that we visited in the Thousand Trails Collection have been just absolutely beautiful. Our favorite park so far that we've stayed in has been in the Trails Collection down in Florida.
That's right. And the only other caveat I would mention is that there are some age restrictions.
Yes.
So in Arizona and Texas and Florida, there are some age qualified parks that you do have to be 55 and up. And whether you're a full timer or a part timer, look closely at that map. Make sure you're going to be going to the places that are in that zone.
If you camp a lot in the summertime or the spring, or you camp more than a month, the camping pass is just right, and it will pay for itself after about 3 weeks of stays.
The next membership that we're going to go over is RPI, and full disclosure, we got our RPI membership for free with our Elite Thousand Trails Connections membership. But generally speaking, the basic would be around $89 when we purchased it. That's how much they were going for. And the gold is $159. And the only downside about those parks is there is a lot of overlap with the Thousand Trails and Encore system. So at first glance, we looked at the map, we thought we were getting all these new parks, and half of them are already included in other memberships. With that said, we have used RPI to fill in the gaps where there are no Thousand Trails or Encore parks. There is a limit of 14 days that you can only stay there for, so just be wary of that. The next one is Good Sam's, and we got that membership for free when we bought our new RV at Camping World. We have other videos talking about that purchasing experience and our experience with the Good Sam's insurances. That membership gives you 10% off of one night stay, sometimes 10% off of three night stay. The Good Sam's membership used to have this really cool app for traveling, but I think they're discontinuing that. Don't quote me on that. But one thing that we've noticed with that membership is that we got so spoiled with Passport America being 50% off that we really don't use the Good Sam's membership. And, you know, we don't see it as a loss because we didn't pay for it, but it's not something that we're really crazy about. The last one we want to talk to you about is Coast to Coast, and these were the sneaky buggers, I tell you what, because they were pitching it, and in the pitch they wanted to sell it for $8,000. Then in a closed room they told us we could get it for $4,500. We asked them to show us a map so we could study the campgrounds to make sure that there wasn't much overlap with our Thousand Trails membership, and here's what we found. They gave us a map of 2014. We made friends with people in the park that were members. They gave us their 2018 booklet, and we compared the two. It was really sneaky because the 2014 had more parks, the icons were smaller. The 2018 had less parks, and the icons were bigger to make it look like it was a whole bunch of campgrounds.
And the other thing that just happened in 2019 is that they've changed the whole, what is it, a good neighbor?
Yeah, there was neighbor parks that were kind of reciprocal, and they've lost some of their reciprocity.
And what they would do is they would lock in a price if you stayed at those parks. It was like $19. Now, you need to call the park. You cannot do it through the system, and there is no set fee. Each park will set their price wherever they want it to be. So that's kind of out the door. The other thing that we weren't crazy about the Coast to Coast is there's a ton of overlap in this program as well with RPI.
And the other reason we had to decline is because when we saw the number of parks participating declining, and yet we look in Thousand Trails and we see them pouring money into the parks, we see them upgrading older parks, we see them adding newer parks to the Encore system. We just couldn't spend $4,000 on an investment in something that we didn't think was growing like the Thousand Trails system is.
Right, and even the people that we spoke to that actually gave us the updated version of the 2018.
Thank you.
They were really nice, and they told us that the parks were shrinking. They had this membership for 20 years, but they did say that it was getting worse. The membership was getting worse, so we decided not to take the risk and purchase the Coast to Coast. We passed on it.
But if you are really in that area often, if there's a lot of parks in your area, it's something you might want to consider. But I would say that Coast to Coast is one that you should do if you're a full-timer, not as a part-timer.
Absolutely. The locations where the Thousand Trail parks are located, they're just in the most beautiful, perfect locations. And for us, it's just a no-brainer. And so, once again, if you're considering the Thousand Trails Elite membership or up, all the way to the Ultimate Odyssey, we give it both thumbs up. But so far, we've loved our membership. All the parks that we've stayed in have been gated. They're all a little bit different. Some are taken really nice care of, some not so much. What we do see and hear from other Thousand Trails members is the system is growing. You know, they're pumping millions of dollars into new infrastructure. They're pumping millions of dollars into expanding the parts, adding new 50-amp service and brand new sites.
So here you have it. If you are a part-timer, definitely look into Passport America. It's a no-brainer. You may want to consider a Thousand Trails camping pass. You might also want to consider RPI depending on the area. If you're full-time, definitely consider the upgraded Thousand Trails memberships. And it's a no-brainer. You got to have the Passport America in your pocket.
Yes.
So don't worry, we got links to all of those memberships below, and don't hesitate to ask us a question, put it in the comments, and if you're a member of any of these campgrounds, let us know what you think, and also if there's one that we missed that you think we should consider, put it in the comments. You RV veterans always know what we should be looking into.
Give us a thumbs up or thumbs down. We'll see you in the next video.
Thank you.
Yes.
And then the parks that are newer and flat and nice and paved, okay.